Power BI, data modeling and shaping. We continue along with our Power BI modeling and shaping course. We are in part 3 now, and we're going to take a look at how to do some parameters and do some extracting of some of the data as we continue to shape this. In parts 1 and 2, we imported the data, went through the Power Query transformations, and started to shape the data. And here in part 3, we start to learn some more advanced features in Power BI. Power BI, data modeling and shaping. At the bottom of the video, there is going to be a link in the description. This is where you get the course materials for the Power BI data modeling and shaping course. If you download the attendee course material, you can follow along. Part 1 and part 2 are already online as we continue along with the data modeling and shaping. Back in Power BI, we continue along with Lab 4A. We're going to create a dynamic path to the Excel source file. In the materials for the course, there is an attendee course material. Look for that in the description below. And inside that folder, data. And inside that data folder is an actuals path text file, a budget path text file, and a number of days text file. And then it does have a couple of Microsoft Excel files. What we are going to do next is create a blank query. And if you open up these text files, there is some code. And the code looks similar to this. And what we're going to do is copy that code, and we are going to paste it into a blank query. So the first thing we're going to do is open up the actuals path, and you are going to highlight the entire code, and you are going to hit Control C or copy, and that is going to copy that code. Then you are going to go back into Power BI, and we're going to put that code into a blank query. Now that we've copied the actuals table query, we are going to go to Get Data, and one of the options is blank query. And what this allows you to do is write a query from scratch. We are on page 26, Lab 4A of the attendee manual, if you're following along as we continue along with the Power BI data modeling and shaping course. So we're going to write a query from the blank query. That brings up the Power Query Editor, and it brings up all of the queries that we've previously done. We've got our path and our actuals file and our budget file. We've got our fact data. We've got our dimension tables. And now if you go to Advanced Editor, bring up the Advanced Editor, this will allow us to paste the code from the actuals path text file that we just copied. So we're going to delete this and hit paste, Control V. And now we have the query data for this blank query. So the only thing we need to do now from that copying and pasting of the query text is we want to name this query. And what we will do now is we are going to call this actuals path. So this query, it's going to be actuals path. And now what we're going to do is go to the campaign dimension, and we want to update the source. So currently the source is the Excel workbook file, and we are going to update the source so that it just changes. Rather than equal Excel workbook, we're going to have it equal the actuals path. And it's got to be the same exact name as you named that parameter. So we've got the actual path query. Now we have campaign dimension, the source. going to be the actuals path. And when you go down now to the change type, you will see that. We now have created the dynamic path for the actuals path. So when you look at the actuals path query, we have the same data that we had for campaign dimension. We have the name, the date, the item, and the kind. And what we're going to do now is we're going to work on the dynamic path to the CSV source file. So again, when you go to the, you will see the data folder, and now you have a budget path. So if you open up that budget path file, we're going to copy this file, copy all of the text with the Control C, or go under File and go Copy. So now we can close that out and go back into Power BI, into the Power Query Editor, and create a new blank query. From that new blank query, we're going to go to the Advanced Editor section. We're going to delete the information that is in there and then hit Control V or Paste. And this will bring in the file path from the budget file. Now that we have the query copied into it, we are going to name this query Budget Path. And then we are going to go into the budget fact table. And for the source, we want it to be equal to the budget path, budget underscore path. So it needs to be the same name as the query, and the query is budget underscore path. And when you go up to the budget fact table, under the source, we want that to be equal to budget path. So that is going to end the 4A and the 4B. Now we move on to lab 4C, which is creating a custom function. Back in Power BI, now we're going to go to lab 4C, which is page 30. If you're following along in the description below, you can click on the link to download the materials. In the data folder, we have already copied over the actuals path and the budget path. There is now a number of days text file. And what we're going to do is copy this, Control C or right click and go copy. Then we close this out. We go back to Power BI. We're going to add a new source, and this is going to be a custom function. So we're going to go to blank query. And under this blank query, we're going to go into the advanced editor and delete the current information and paste the query from the data that we just copied. And then when we copy this, we now have a custom function, and we're going to name this FN, and we're going to have days since year start. So this is our custom function. We've copied the query, we've named the query, and we're ready to get this custom function going. Now we've created the custom function, which is the number of days since the year start. So you're starting to see all of our queries on the left-hand side. We've got the original campaign dimension, date dimension. We created the category segment dimension. We updated the budget fact table. Then we created the actuals path, the budget path, and the function. Now we're going to create and manage our parameters. So if you go up to the parameters, we are going to make a new parameter. The parameter is going to be called transaction date. And this is going to be a date parameter. And the current value is going to be 1/1/2011. So this is going to be our parameter, which is called transaction date. And to invoke this parameter, we need to go to the sales query. So click on the sales query, and we're going to add a column, and we're going to invoke a custom function. If you look up here, you've got your column from examples, your custom column. We're going to invoke a custom column in order to do that. So when we add this column, and the new column name is going to be days from year start, and the function query, we only have one function query. It already automatically will come up under the drop down arrow list, will be the days since year start, and the transaction date is going to be the current date from the calendar. The new column name is going to be days from year start. The function query is the only function query that we have done, so from the drop-down menu. Now the transaction date is going to be the current date. So I'm recording this on August 16th, 2023. Whatever date you're doing this on, you will put the current date in the transaction date. And then that will bring in the days from year start column on the right-hand side, and it's going to be set up. And all we need to do now is go back to the home screen and close and apply the changes to Power Query. And then we're going to close and change, save the file. So we're going to save the file. We're done with Lab 4. We're going to move on to Lab 5, which is creating new measures and new columns as we continue to shape and load up your model and create your data model in Power BI. So we created in Lab 4, we got the custom function in, we added the custom function, and we also created some additional tables in Power Query. Lab 5, we're going to create the new measures and the columns. Make sure to save it here to close out Lab 4. Back in Power BI, we continue along. We have completed Lab 4. In Lab 5, we are going to start off with creating some measures and columns and show you the DAX method of creating measures. So we have all of our tables on the right-hand side, and we will drag this out so you can see this a little bit better. And the first thing we're going to do is click on the sales table. You have two areas where you can create a new measure. You can go under the table tools and create a new measure, or you can right click on sales and create a new measure. So we are going to create a new measure, and this one is going to be called total units sold, and it's going to equal the sum of sales. And now you have what's called IntelliSense. When you start to type in the table name, all of the different columns will come up as being available to create the measure. And we're going to go to the sum of the sales units. By hitting tab, that will select, and then you will just close it out with the right parentheses. And then you'll notice over in your sales table, you have a measure called total units sold, and it is the sum of the sales units. So we will now format the total units sold, and by clicking on it, and we are going to change this to a whole number. Now we're going to create a calculated column. So from the sales table again, you can either create a column from the table tools at the top, or you can create a column by right-clicking and selecting new column. So we created the calculated column, but now we need to build out a relationship so that these are actually connected. So the first thing we're going to do is from the category segment dimension, we have an ID, and we have a category segment ID from the budget fact table. So we're going to make that a one-to-many relationship. Then from the product dimension, we have a category segment ID, and we're going to connect that to the budget fact table. We're going to create a one-to-many relationship. And also from the customer dimension, we have a customer ID, and we want to create a relationship to the customer ID in the sales table. So we now can start to build out some of these dimensions. The only other thing is we have a campaign dimension ID, and we want to create that relationship to the sales table. And the product dimension ID is we have a geo dimension, we have a zip code, and we want to create the product ID from the sales table. So now we've built out the rest of the relationship to this table. We need to build out some more relationships, and the next from the relationship view, you need from the product dimension table to the sales table, we need to have the product ID. And if we create the product ID to the product ID, that creates a one-to-many relationship. And then from the customer dimension table, we also have this connected to the geo dimension. So we're starting to build out the relationship table because this requires a relationship between the campaign dimension and the product dimension. So we have the campaign dimension here, and now we have the product dimension. And the only thing that can connect those two is we have a campaign ID, and we need to connect those two for the relationship. Once you make the changes to the relationship model, you want it to look like the diagram on page 24 of the attendee workbook. And the description, the link below, will have the download materials for all parts of this shaping and modeling class. So once you have your relationship set up, then the column category for the related, what this does when you look in the data view, it brings in the category and the campaign from the related table. And that's why you have the comma category slash campaign. It brings in the category and the campaign from the related table. So now we have a measure, which is the calculator icon. Then we have the calculated column icon, which is a grid with an FX, and that means it's a calculated column. The next step is to start to see some of the visualization. So if you go to your sales table and click and drag the total units sold, it creates a visualization, and we're going to make this a clustered column chart. So now we have total units sold, and we can start to work on the visualizations. So if we bring in the units underneath on this visual, we will start to see the total units sold is the same as the units. And this will be important as you start to see some of the different visualizations. Now we're going to select device from the campaign dimension table and bring that into this grid. And now we have the desktop, paper, mobile, tablet, and desktop. So those are some of the devices that are available for this campaign. Now we're going to go to Lab 6, which is to create a report for the VP in charge of the youth and accessory segment. So we're going to go and create a few more measures so that way we can actually build out a report. So we're going to put this visualization off to the side, and we're going to start to build out some more additional measures from the sales table. From our table tools, we're going to select new measure. This is the second way that you can create a measure rather than right clicking. And it's going to be youth units sold. And that's the name of the measure. And then the syntax is going to be calculate left parenthesis. Then we're going to put a bracket for the total units sold, which is the name of the measure. And this is going to put a new context on it. And the filter, which is another data category of DAX, is going to be the product dimension table. And then it's going to be the product dimension. And it's going to be the segment. The segment we want is equal to the youth. And it needs to be in parentheses because it's text. So what this will do is create a new measure that takes the filter of the segment, which is youth, and then calculates, modifies that total units sold. So that is going to be the new measure. The second measure we're going to create from the sales table is going to be the accessory units sold, which now we're basically going to focus in on the accessory units sold, and we're going to use the formula, which is again the name. Then we're going to use the calculate, and we're going to use a left parentheses. Then the name of the measure that we want to change the context is total units sold. We're going to close that bracket out. Then we're going to filter it by the product dimension table. And that's going to be product dimension with the segment. And the segment is going to be equal to accessory. And this will create the accessory units sold. The next calculation we're going to make for the measure is going to be the rest of the company units sold, which is equal to calculate the total units sold, comma, filter all of the product dimension, and the product dimension segment is not equal to accessory, or the product dimension segment is not equal to youth. So now we have the accessory units sold, we have the rest of the company units sold, and the total units sold for measures, and then the youth units sold. So we are going to format the rest of the company sold, and we're going to change the whole number and a comma, and we're going to go to the youth units sold and create a comma for the formatting, and the accessory units sold and add a comma to the formatting. So now we're going to add a table visual inside the report view. We'll delete this last one that was a sample. And this is a table measure. And what we're going to bring in now is the device from the campaign. And then we're going to bring in the rest of the company units sold. We're going to bring in the youth units sold. And we're going to bring in the accessory units sold. So now we see the breakdown by the different measures. Next, we, after the table, we are going to be, if you're following along, we are on page 40 of the attendee guide. We are going to create a line chart. And with this line chart, we're going to add in on the x-axis from the date dimension table, we're going to add in the year. Then on the y-axis, we're going to add in the accessory units sold. And then we're also going to add in from the sales table the measure youth units sold. So now we have a line chart that shows by year accessory units sold and also the youth units sold. So now we're going to create another measure, and it's going to be cost of goods sold. And this is going to use a sumx and a related function. Next, we want to analyze some of our measures. And we have added three new measures to the table. We have added a cost of goods sold, which is calculated, if you're following along, page 41 in the attendee guide. Cost of goods sold equals sumx times sales units times related of the product dimension unit cost. So it's pulling in the data from the one side to the many side, and sumx means it calculates row by row the cost of goods sold. So that's the first measure. Then we calculate a sales amount, which is the sumx of sales units times the unit price from the product dimension table. So for every time, every line in the sales table, it finds the product ID, then it brings in the product price. Then the profit is the third measure, which is the sumx of the sales units times the related minus the related cost. So the price minus the cost, and then add all of those up and times it by the sumx. So those are the three measures that we have created, and this will help us analyze the profit as we go into lab 7A. And now we have all of those additional measures. We'll add a few more measures, and we're getting close to finalizing the data modeling and shaping. To wrap up lab 7 of the first part of the data modeling and shaping course, we close it out with three different measures. One of them is going to be the year-to-date total units sold, which is the total LYTD, which is the sum of the sales units, and then the date dimension date. Then we have the previous year total units sold, which is on page 42 of the manual. You'll calculate the year-to-date total units sold, same period last year, and then we can take a look at the growth percentage. So now when you start to have some of these additional measures, you can do things like compare previous year to last year. If we wanted to insert a new card chart, we could bring in the profit, 17.7 million. And we could also bring in overall, if we click on a blank area, we can bring in the growth percentage. So those are just some of the different measures that we are calculating out. And for data modeling and shaping, the process is to bring in your data, then you start to build your relationships, then you build your measures. We showed you how to duplicate a dimension table, and then you could add in and bring in that category ID for the segment ID. So that is the data modeling and shaping course. Remember to click in the link below for the description to download the attendee materials and follow along parts 1, 2, and 3. And that is a look at the data modeling and shaping course straight from Power BI. We're going to have additional models and data modeling courses here on the channel.